Thanks for that introduction, Leon. Today, there are many cytotoxic agents and targeted therapies available for cancer, but still many patients develop resistance to therapies. This ineffective treatment can not only lead to a significant economic burden, but also to the development of much more aggressive cancers. One of the main reasons for this therapeutic resistance and poor patient survival is a phenomenon called tumor heterogeneity, one of the main challenges facing clinical oncology today. So say I have a bunch of apples and one of them is rotten. I take a snapshot and ask you to describe the photo. A traditional bulk bioassay will give me this information, essentially an average of all pixel values. A single cell bioassay might give me much higher resolution, but without any contextual information. What we are developing is a spatially resolved bioassay that can retain this contextual information. So why is this important? Just like this bunch of apples, a tumor is heterogeneous, and this variability makes it difficult for treatments to eliminate the entire tumor. So what is the spatially resolved information we are detecting? It comes from a highly promising biomarker for cancer called microRNA. These are short non-coding RNA that have very important gene regulatory functions. But in cancer, their levels get deregulated through either overexpression or underexpression of the microRNA in the tumor compared to normal tissue. Now, it turns out that just detecting the levels of microRNA is not enough to make informed clinical decisions. There are two further requirements, and the first is spatial information. This study has shown that detecting low levels of microRNA, specifically in the stroma of the tissue, predicted a positive patient outcome. However, if it was detected in the tumor, it would predict a poor patient outcome. Now, other studies have shown the same thing, that the location of microRNA in a tissue is very crucial to making accurate clinical predictions. Now, the second requirement is multiplexing, that is, the ability to detect not one, but a whole panel of microRNA. And this allows you to differentiate between normal and cancer tissue, but importantly, to distinguish between benign and malignant tumors. Now, unfortunately, there are no current techniques that can simultaneously satisfy both criteria. A bulk sample bioassay may offer multiplexing, but it lacks spatial resolution, and a spatially resolved bioassay such as FISH offers limited multiplexing and long, laborious workflows. There is thus an unmet clinical and technological gap to be filled. And for this, we propose our project. We have assembled a team of microRNA experts from VIDMC, headed by Professor Frank Sack, as well as a team of experts in microtechnologies and biosensing from MIT, headed by Professor Patrick Doyle. And together, we developed a technology for spatially resolved and multiplex microRNA detection, all in a format that fits perfectly into the standard pathology workflow. So you start with a formalin-fixed, paraffin-embedded tissue, and this is the standard, with no sample preparation, short assay times, and a single fluorophore is required. So how does this work? It's based on a nanoliter well array, and you can think of this as a densely packed grid of square wells. Each well is like a pixel in an image, and the wells are filled with microRNA detecting hydrogel posts, shown in blue, as well as lysis reagents. The posts are functionalized with DNA probes targeted towards your microRNA of interest. Now, what you can do is press this array against the tissue section, and the lysis reagents will digest the tissue, releasing the microRNA, which is then captured by the posts in a spatially resolved manner. So how would this work in practice? What I've got here is an H&E stained tissue section from a genetically engineered mouse model for non-small cell lung cancer. And a pathologist would be able to identify the three tumor regions as labeled herein, 1, 2, 3, as well as the normal adjacent tissue. But all three regions look exactly the same, and there are no further information apparent in order to inform clinical decisions. Our platform is able to provide this information. And here's just a fraction of it. For example, seeing that microRNA 21 is overexpressed in region 1, a clinician might prescribe treatment A. But now seeing that microRNA 19B is overexpressed in region 3 might indicate resistance to this initial treatment. So then a clinician would prescribe treatment B instead. And now combining all this information, a clinician would be able to devise the most appropriate and personalized treatment strategy effective against eliminating the entire heterogeneous tumor. Overall, our platform represents the only spatially resolved and multiplexed microRNA bio assay. We believe it can be used by researchers to better understand tumor heterogeneity, but also by clinicians in order to devise the most informed treatment plans. We're now working with our clinical collaborators at the IDMC on a human breast cancer study. And in the future, we'd be interested to talk to potential investors as well as companies with synergistic technologies. With your support, we hope to tackle one of the major challenges facing clinical oncology today, leading to much better patient outcomes and a lower economic burden. Thank you all for listening.